This video is to review the most recent scientific evidence on the effects of foam rolling. We'll go through three potential effects of foam rolling, three potential theories behind it, and three limitations of this study. And also I will finish with my opinion on it. So let's have a look at their findings. This is the most recent systematic review with 21 studies included. Out of the 21 studies, 14 studies used pre-rolling, which means they used the foam roller before exercising, and the remaining 7 used post-rolling, which means after exercises. Their conclusion is this. They said there is a short-term effect of increasing joint range of motion without decreasing muscle performance, which is expected because your muscles get warmed up with foam rolling. That's why you can move better. Secondly, they suggest that foam rolling before exercises may improve sports performance. Some studies found it was slightly effective for elite sprinters, but not for jump or strength performance. However, the effect size is so small with only 0.7% improvement. They also mentioned it may be just a psychological effect where the sprinters just felt better and more confident after foam rolling. Although it can be just placebo effect, psychological aspects play an important role in most sports, especially at an elite level. So if you're an elite sprinter, you may consider foam rolling before sprinting. What's more interesting is they found a positive effect of foam rolling on alleviating muscle soreness if it's used after exercising. According to this study, 66% of the population is likely to experience reduced muscle pain by foam rolling after exercises. So let's have a look at how it works. The first potential theory behind it is scar tissue breaking down. You might have heard that there is some sort of knot or scar tissue between, you know, muscle fibers, and by foam rolling your muscles, you can get rid of them. A lot of people assume that way, but unfortunately, it's an assumption only at this stage. It may be, but so far there's no scientific evidence on foam rolling breaking down the scar tissue. Another explanation is that you could potentially warm up your muscles by moving your body during foam rolling. Your muscles have to activate to maintain these positions, which induce preactivation and warm-up effects. The last one is changes in pain perception. This is probably the most plausible explanation, that the sensation or the pain during foam rolling overrides the actual pain signals induced by painful muscles or injuries. Simply put, you trick your brain into paying more attention to the pain sensation from foam rolling rather than actual muscle pain or injury pain, basically increasing pain threshold. There are three limitations in this study. Firstly, sample sizes and effect sizes are small, which result in reduced statistical power. Second, none of the included studies were able to blind their subjects to the treatment. That's because of the nature of the foam rolling technique. So if you are involved in one study about medication, you take a pill without knowing what's the medication about. You may be given the actual medication that the researchers are testing, or you may be just given vitamin or, you know, painkiller. But in this type of study, because of the nature of the foam rolling, all the subjects already knew they're going to do foam rolling and they would have expected something is going to get better, which can impact on the result of the studies. This is a placebo effect. Also, each study used different protocols and tools. We don't know how much pressure each subject may have used. Some people might have applied light pressure, while the others might have done harder. Although there are more studies recommending firm foam rollers. So taken altogether, the physiological mechanisms of the potential benefits of foam rolling are not fully understood. It's not the scar tissue breaking down as many people might have heard of or just assumed, but I'd rather say it is the effects of the movements we make during foam rolling and the pain perception changes. So this is why I show you the muscle release techniques before exercising in this channel. Pain control is an important part of any rehab, so I think massaging or foam rolling targeted muscles will help warm up that muscles and potentially reduce the pain level. And the best part is, it is a safe way to do that, as there is almost no side effects reported in this study. To sum up, foam rolling does not seem to improve muscle functions whether it's used before or after exercises. However, there seems to be a positive effect on alleviating muscle soreness if it's used after exercises, even though it can be just a psychological effect or simply changes in, you know, pain perception. Despite all this, I believe science can't explain everything yet, because it's almost impossible to do this kind of research in a good setting due to the nature of the foam rolling. Anyway, based on what they've found so far, I definitely recommend foam rolling before exercising if you are in a rehab process, because you need to reduce your pain perception before exercising, otherwise you can't do the exercises, right? And if you're just a regular exerciser, foam rolling after exercises is recommended to reduce muscle soreness. There may be some potential effects that haven't been found yet. Therefore, my personal opinion is to do this kind of muscle release as often as possible, because there is no harm anyway unless you do too hard. In fact, I do them all the time because it just feels good doing that. I'll see you next time. Cheers.
운동 안 하면 아무 소용 없다.